Wala pang kalahating buwan, naubos na daw ang 125 million. Supposedly to fund surveillance of 132 areas. This amounts to 11 million pesos spent per day for these surveillance activities conducted over the holidays. Lumalabas po, mahigit 11 million po sa isang araw ang ginagastos po nila sa surveillance activities. Kasama na po dito ang Pasko.
Na-mention kanina ni Chairman, the Honorable Joel Chua, na in the accomplishment report of the President, if I remember it right, meron pong ginamit na yung surveillance in 132 places. Tama ba ba, Mr. Chair?
Yung areas po yun.
Narinig ko na yun.
132 areas po.
Yes.
Yung 125 million, parang ginamit po yan in 132 areas.
Yes, and accordingly, it was 100% compliance. Hindi po ba sa tingin ng COA, medyo kwan ito? Medyo imposible? Kami po ay gumagamit din po ng intelligence fund. Ay nanggaling po ako sa service . At alam ko na mahirap gawin ito. I will conduct surveillance in 132 areas in 11 days. Tapos kayo ngayon, sa COA, sinasabi ninyo na posible pala ito. Samantalang kami on the ground na gumagawa nito noong ako'y nasa servisyo, nahirapan po kami. So, what is your basis na pwedeng sabihin na posible ito, Madam COA?
Enzo Recto, kalaban ang katiwalian at kasinungalingan, kakampi sa katotohanan at kabutihan.
Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. I would like to start by making some things very clear before we start the proceedings today. I have heard, and I assume many of us here have heard, accusations and insinuations regarding this committee and these proceedings, implying that this is somehow a political exercise or an attack on an individual. I would like to make things very clear. This is not the case. At this point, I will apologize to some of the people watching as I will be mentioning a lot of numbers during my remarks. This is necessary in order to make clear that it is not any enmity, passion, or hostility which drives this committee. It is simply a case of numbers that do not make sense. This is why, if you would recall, last week's hearing focused on the issue of confidential funds. Ano ba ang confidential fund na ito at bakit ito importante? Ano ang kinalaman nito sa accountability? Based on Joint 2015-01 of the COA, confidential funds are funds disbursed to, among others, national government agencies for their confidential expenses. On the other hand, confidential expenses are those relating to surveillance activities which support the operations of the agency. So sa madaling salita, ang confidential funds ay pera para sa mga operasyon ng pagbabantay at pagmamanman ukol sa mga aktibidad ng ahensya. While this may seem to be a very specific definition, we cannot help but notice that the joint circular provides very loose requirements for the release of confidential funds to agencies and also requires less specific information and documents in order to liquidate and account for. In Notice of Disallowance number 2024-002-100, the COA disallowed the amount of over 73 million pesos, representing almost 60% of the 125 million pesos in confidential funds. Pwede po ba yung slide? Paki-present. Almost 60% of the 125 million pesos in confidential funds allocated to the OVP in 2022. Equally significant is the fact that this amount was indicated to have been fully spent over the period of 11 days. Wala pang kalahating buwan, naubos na daw ang 125 million. Supposedly to fund surveillance of 132 areas. This amounts to 11 million pesos spent per day for these surveillance activities conducted over the holidays. Lumalabas po, mahigit 11 million po sa isang araw ang ginagastos po nila sa surveillance activities. Kasama na po dito ang Pasko. I note that while these numbers are already staggering, this is only a portion of what this committee is investigating and dealing with. In fiscal year 2023, the OVP received half a billion pesos in confidential funds. This includes the 125 million mentioned above, disbursed in 2022. In addition to this amount, spent in 11 days, the OVP was disbursed 125 million per quarter for the first three quarters of 2023. The entirety of which has been questioned by the COA through Audit Observation Memorandum o yung tinatawag po nating AOM. In other words, one of the 500 million we are talking about, only about 10% or 51 million has been definitively allowed by COA. Sa 500 million po, halos 10% lamang po ang pinayagan ng COA at sinabing walang problema. At ito po yung nagkakahalaga ng 51 million. When one goes deeper and looks at the liquidation reports for these disbursements, a disturbing pattern and similarity emerges with perfectly round numbers. Ni isang sentimo po ay walang butal. Being attributed to expenses such as medicine and food, paulit-ulit po at parang kinapipaste ang liquidation ng confidential funds ng OVP. With this in mind, to all but the most biased observers, it should be very easy to see why this committee has chosen to investigate the possibility of gaps in the regulation of confidential funds, as it is possible that we have seen these gaps exploited before our very eyes. What we have seen regarding the usage by the OVP of its confidential funds certainly gives this committee and the country cause to want to find out the facts behind this. Ultimately, to fulfill this August body's mandate of crafting effective laws and legislations to protect our people's hard-earned money. This committee is understandably very alarmed at these reports implying misuse of public funds. In particular, because of the astronomical, almost unimaginable amount of money involved. I must stress at this point that the sheer vastness of these potentially misused funds sets this matter apart from other instances of irregularity and disallowance. These amounts easily surpass the threshold for the crime of plunder under our laws. it is incumbent upon us who are duty bound to ensure that our legislation and regulations are effective enough to protect the money of the people, to investigate and get to the bottom of these glaring irregularities. As we begin today's hearing, I must make this clear. This committee is not about politics, not about attacks. It is not even about the release or approval of any budget, as some have implied. This investigation is not prompted by any motive other than a desire to make the numbers make sense. This committee and these proceedings are about accountability. We seek to learn the truth of how public money, ang pera ng taong bayan, is being used, whether or not our current laws, rules, and procedures are sufficient to ensure the security and safety of these funds. Maraming salamat po.
Line item, confidential expenses. Kailan po nyo na-release yung COA report nyo?
Sino po ang sasagot? Attorney, sorry, hindi ko po makita yung pangalan. Attorney Camora from COA, please proceed.
Good morning, Mr. Chair. As to confidential intelligence and confidential funds, we do not issue any audit reports, just the audit actions, Mr. Chair.
Audit action.
Yes, Mr.
Yes.
Chair.
Okay, thank you for the clarification. Now, when was the confidential fund in the amount of 125 million transferred to the office of the Vice President?
Sino po sasagot?
It was in December.
Attorney Camora?
December.
Mr. Chair, may I be clarified? The cash advance, Mr. Chair?
Yes. When was the fund, the 125 million amount, transferred to the office of the Vice President?
Mr. Chair, the fund was received on December 2022, Mr.
Okay.
Chair.
Thank you. Now, on 25 September 2023, according to reports, kayo po ay nag-confirm, maybe because of reports na galing po sa Office of the Vice President, na the amount of 125 million confidential funds was spent in 11 days.
Mr. Chair, based on their liquidation reports, opo.
Kayo po ang nagsabi nito in your report.
Wala pong report, Mr. Chair, but audit action po.
Oh, it's an audit action. At kinoconfirm yes, nyo na yung amount na 125 million was spent by the Office of the Vice President in 11 days. And that would be amounting to 11.3 thereabouts million per day. Would that be correct? Tama po ba yun?
Mr. Chair, may I ask for the question to be repeated?
Ano po? Uulitin ko po?
Opo.
Kayo po nagko-confirm na in-spend in your liquidation in the liquidation report that was submitted to you, kayo po nag-confirm na in 11 days naubos po yung 125 million confidential funds. Tama po?
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
And that is equivalent to spending 11.3 million a day if it was spent, or if the amount was spent in 11 days. Tama po rin po ah.
Tama po, Mr. Chair, based on their documents po.
Yung 11 days na yon ay nung panahon na from 21 to 31 ng December 2022. Would that also be correct? O tama po ba yun?
Based on their accomplishment report, tama po, Mr. Chair.
And that is at the height of the holiday season, matatapos na po yung taon. Di po ba?
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
At lahat po ng ahensya ng gobyerno nagmamadali na ma-spend yung kanilang pera na nasa kanilang opisina. Di po ba? Kasi ang nangyayari po, di ba, kung minsan, December 31, pinapaspasan po ng mga opisina ng gobyerno ang pag-liquidate po ng mga pondo na nasa kanila. Di po ba tama yun? Alam ko po yun dahil naging controller po ako ng Philippine National Police noong chief PNPC, Senator Lacson, at yun ang nangyayari eh. Kayo po ang sasagot, hindi na po siya.
That's correct po, Your Honor.
Yes.
Paki-address niyo po yung chair sa antakantayin niyo po na recognize kayo. You are Miss Sofia Gemora?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay, please continue.
Kasi minamadali po nila ng mga ehensya dahil if you notice, yung buwan ng Disyembre, normally it has four non-working holidays. So, apat na ang nabawas sa 11 days para gastusin mo. Tama rin po ba?
If I may add, Your Honor, to the what Attorney Gemora had said earlier, with regards to the 11 days report of our audit team, we are the audit team of the Office of the Vice President. So, looking at the records or the recording in the financial statements, we found out that the cash advance was drawn on December 20, 2022, and on December 31, looking at the financial statements, there was an expenditures recorded of the same amount, the 125 million. So that was the reason why we, of course, correct to say that that was the 125 million was expended in 11 days. Your Honor.
Thank you, Madam. Now, because of this, COA issued a notice of disallowance dated 8 August 2024, disallowing the amount of 73,287,000 from the 125 million confidential funds disbursed by the Office of the Vice President in 2022. Tama rin po ba?
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
Now, may I know kung ano po yung mga dahilan po ninyo bakit nag-issue po kayo ng notice of disallowance doon po sa expenditure on confidential funds by the Office of the Vice President? Pwede po bang malaman yung rason po ninyo?
Attorney Gemora.
Mr. Chair, our reasons were indicated po at the ND. I'd like to make a rundown po. Yung may issue po sa payment of rewards nila, may issue sa payment of table charging payment for tables, chairs, desktop computers and printers to the confidential fund, and also a non-submission of the revised accomplishment report, Mr. Chair.
Yun po yung official reason why you COA issued a notice of disallowance. Tama rin po?
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
Now, may I ask, meron po siguro kayong breakdown ng expenditure of the confidential funds? Meron po ba kayo?
Mr. Chair, meron po sa accomplishment report.
Yes, and yung breakdown po ng expenditure ng 125 million, nasa inyo po sigurado yun. Tama rin po?
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
Now, may I know kung saan po nagastos ng Office of the Vice President yung 125 million? Was it spent in accordance with the rules, regulations, and protocol on the expenditure or on the use of confidential funds? Nasunod po ba yun?
Yes, Mr. Chair. As indicated sa accomplishment report po, na liquidate naman po nila based on confidential expenses as required by the joint circular po, Mr. Chair.
If I may, alam naman po ninyo yung section 4.8 of joint circular number 2015-01.
Yes, Mr.
On the
Chair.
Use of confidential funds.
Opo, Mr. Chair.
Now, categorically, yung po bang items na kung saan ginamit yung confidential funds ay naaayon po dito sa circular na ito?
Opo, Mr. Chair.
Kung naaayon sa circular na ito, bakit kayo nag-issue ng notice of disallowance?
Mr. Chair, as to yung first finding, meron po kasing specific requirement ang joint circular na document na hindi po nila na-submit or nag-submit sila pero hindi po sufficient siya to answer the requirement of the joint circular, Mr. Chair.
Na-mention kanina ni Chairman, the Honorable Joel Chua, na in the accomplishment report of the President, if I remember it right, meron pong ginamit na yung surveillance in 132 places. Tama ba ba, Mr. Chair? Yung
areas po yun.
Narinig ko na yun.
132 areas po.
Yes.
Yung 125 million, parang ginamit po yan in 132 areas.
Yes. Accordingly, it was 100% compliance. Hindi po ba sa tingin ng COA medyo kwan ito? Medyo imposible?
Mr. Chair, parang based on other ano, parang okay lang naman po siya.
Kami po ay gumagamit din po ng intelligence fund. Ay nanggaling po ako sa service eh. At alam ko na mahirap gawin ito. I will conduct surveillance in 132 areas in 11 days. Tapos kayo ngayon sa COA sinasabi ninyo na posible pala ito. Samantalang kami on the ground na gumagawa nito noong ako'y nasa serbisyo, nahirapan po kami. So, what is your basis na pwedeng sabi na posible ito, Madam COA?
Mr. Chair, there are also deficiencies here.
No, tinatanong ko lang po kayo kasi sa mata po ng COA, yung mag-conduct ka ng surveillance activities in 132 areas in 11 days, para sa amin po na gumagawa nito in our use of intelligence funds, no, ako po yung nasa servisyo, nahirapan po kami eh. Tapos sa mata pala ninyo, posibleng-posible pala ito. Tama po ba yung aking kaisipan?
Mr. Chair, ang identified lang po ay number of areas, pero pwede din pong i-consider yung kung ilan po yung kung ilang tao po yung pinag-spendan ng funds, Mr. Chair.
But the liquidation report does not say so.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
In-assume na lang ninyo yun eh.
May hulaanong salita na ang ibig sabihin dito ay ang pagkakaisa.
Bunyog Party List.
Halika na, Bunyog Party List ka na. Halika na, Bunyog Party List ka na.
Sa susunod, ang atinang suportahan, Bunyog Party List. Nagtataguyod ng katotohanan, lumalaban para sa bayan.